ورحمة الله وبركاته. Welcome back my friends to my YouTube channel Drilling and Workover. This is me, I am Abdelaziz Gabr. I am accredited instructor for IWCF Well Control and IEDC Well Sharp. Also, I am accredited instructor in IEDC Mud Engineering for Basic and Advanced Mud School. Today, inshallah, we will talk about a new topic in the advanced mud school. It's called the stress cage techniques. And inshallah, we will talk later about also the particle size distribution technique. This is a very important topic. So please, please take all the notes that I will talk about today and revise it again because this is a very important lesson. First of all, what does it mean by bridging the particle optimization tool or the BBOT, or what is known as the particle size distribution? Okay. For example, we have yesterday talked about the drill in fluids. Okay, and from the drill in fluids, we have talked about the filtration. And we know that the filtration could be controlled by two methods. Number one is the bridging agent. Number two is the fluid loss reducers additives. Okay. So the bridging agents are mainly like the LCM. Okay. They are like the LCM materials, but in different sizes. Okay. So the best backing or the optimization of the backing mechanism is to use a blend, or what is it? A blend of different sizes of the bridging material. What is the meaning of the blend? Blend means mixture. Okay, so we have to use coarse, medium, fine, and ultra fine bridging material. Okay. For example, in order to for everything to be clear for you, if we have a micro fracture, okay, in the formation, and we need to fill it with material, okay, or if we have, for example, also a depleted zone, and we need to fill the outer surface of it with the bridging material. So how can we make ideal backing to the bridging material? Number one, for example, if we used only coarse material, okay, like this watermelon, you see they have a lot of vugs in between them, okay, a lot of vugs in between them. So if we used the coarse one or the medium one only, the filtrate will be also high, and you will not get proper results, okay. But if we added in these vugs, okay, some like the tomatoes here, okay, or the medium or the fine, okay, we use here medium and we use here the fine sizes to be in between these vugs, actually the passing areas will be very small, okay, so it enhances more and more about the filtrate, for example, okay. And if we use a blend of the three, we use also grapes, which has very fine compared to the watermelon for sure, very fine size of the grapes, for example, and we will put it here, okay, and both of them are put here in the vugs, so the total will make very consistent and very hard filter cake, and it cannot be penetrated, or for example the filtrate will not be very high. Okay, this is known as the particle size distribution. How about the amounts used from the medium and from the fine and from the ultra fine? What about the amounts? Okay, so the amounts, for example, if we use 10 pound per barrel of medium and 20 pound per barrel of the fine, and for example 30 pound per barrel of the ultra fine, okay, how I know about these doses or these concentrations? This is what is known as the particle size distribution, and it is used in stress cage techniques. Okay, so We have some introduction about this issue, okay? For historically, the rule provided by Abrams, which was the first scientist who talked about the particle size distribution, has been used for this purpose, okay? According to this rule, the median particle size, the median particle size, which means the average, okay? The average particle size of the bridging agent should be equal to or slightly greater than 1/3 of the mean pore size for a given target formation. What is the meaning of this, of these words? For example, if you have a dolomite which has a pore size, for example, with the millidarcy, okay, with the micron, okay, so that in order to make a bridge or to make an effective bridging to this hole or to this pore size, you have to use bridging agents, and its particle size is 1/3 of the pore size of the formation. Okay. Also, for example, as I told you, the 50 micrometer particles are effective at sealing bores up to or around 150 micrometer in diameter. However, Abrams' rule only addresses the size of particle required to initiate the bridge, not the particle size distribution. It's just for initiation of the bridge, and after this we add the other fine over it, okay, after we have discovered this after some time. It doesn't give optimum size or address the best backing sequence of particle size for minimizing fluid invasion and optimizing the sealing. So what is the best backing sequence, or how can we get the best backing sequence of the particles? Here, as you see here, Abrams, he told us that the median of the particles, okay, in order to make some effective sealing, it has to be 1/3 of this bore size, so that more than one can be added and can lead to better to make the sealing from here and reduce the filtration. But actually this will not get the better results required. So if we use big one or coarse one, then medium, then fine, then ultra fine, and make a blend of them by making particle size distribution, we will make better reducing to the filter loss. Okay, it will be reduced very much. Okay, and we can check for this by two tests. The first test is the high P high T or high pressure high temperature test, and the other test is called the BBT or permeability plugging tester. This is very important. Okay, and we are making this by using the histogram, okay, of the calcium carbonate. For example, this is for the ultra fine or very fine, this is for the fine one, and this is for the medium and for the coarse. Okay, so the ideal backing theory is what is the definition? It's the ideal backing can be defined as the full range of particle size distribution required to effectively seal all voids, okay, including those created by bridging agents. This subsequent layering of the of bridging agents results in a tighter and less invading filter cake. It makes tight filter cake with and less invading one. Okay, the ideal packing theory uses either bore sizing from thin section analysis or using the permeability of the formation, okay, to make the combined with the particle size distribution of the bridging material to determine the ideal backing sequence. So the ideal backing sequence depends on two things. Number one is the permeability of the formation, and number two is the particle size distribution done by the program of software or something like this. Okay, the ideal backing can be achieved by blending, which was the meaning of blending is mixing, okay? Mixing various size bridging agents to seal a broad range of permeability and pore size or fracture width, okay? It has been found that 2-3% by volume, or about 20-30 pound per barrel of a proper blend of bridging agent can provide the optimum seal on the surface or on the face of permeable zones in clean fluids. Okay, this is introduction about the particle size distribution. What is the meaning by stress cage techniques? Actually, how to manage a drilling well? Okay, once if you need to make to drill well with very smooth, for example, you have to make to follow up the best drilling practices at first, and we will talk about the best drilling practices later, inshallah. Number two, you have to make a proper selection to the drilling fluids, for example, oil-based mud for the shale or KCL inhibited plus all these types. Okay. Number three, to use the well bore strengthening material, okay, which are mainly bridging materials, okay. But it has very strong or very strong. It has very high strength. Okay. And finally, to make sure, about the LCM or loss of circulation material that will be used in case of high losses or severe losses are encountered during drilling this well. Okay. So we will talk now about the well bore strengthening materials. The principle of stress cage theory, as I told you, is depositing of solids at the mouth of the induced fractures, which will act as a propant and consequently isolate fluid pressure in the well bore from the majority of the fracture. What does this mean? Okay, what this means? Actually, we are drilling with overbalance. Okay, the overbalance creates micro fractures in the formation. These micro fractures are stuffed, okay, with the solids or with the bridging material that we are adding in a very special sequence, okay. So that it leads to make a very strong wall, wall of the well bore, and hence it can isolate the pressure, the fluid pressure in the well bore from the majority of the fractures. Okay, the fluid, and there are some fluid traps or trapped behind the bridge. Okay, this trapped pressure makes the behind the particles makes them more consolidated. Okay, it makes them more consolidated because there is overbalance from the well and there is a trapped pressure behind them, so they are under pressure from both sides, so they become more consolidated. Okay, and they are also dissipated into the formation. So the fracture can be closed, okay, can be closed over the solids or over the high strength material, and so that it makes very strong well bore wall for the well bore, okay, for the well. As a result, an increased hope stress at the near well bore region and increased the force required to open the fracture further, okay. What are the results? The results is extended leak of test. Okay, extended leak of test. And as you see here, for example, if you make leak of test, okay, this is the general leak of test. Okay, it gives you the result, for example, for here. And the fracture or the original formation breakdown pressure is here. But after making strengthening to the formation, it becomes more stronger and can withstand more pressure. So it enhances the leak of pressure, the leak of pressure test. Okay. This is what we are was that we have said from minutes ago. This is as you see here. This is the wheel bore and this is the formation. Okay. This is high overbalance here, makes micro fracture as you see here, and this micro fracture is contains the fluid, okay, contains the fluid with the solids or with the bridging material inside it, okay. This inside these bridging materials, okay, has overbalance from here, and the trapped pressure from here are making the those to become very solid or very consolidated, and hence they make very strength or they make strengthening to the wall of the well bore. Okay, that is the other picture about what we have already talked. Okay, the hope stress enhancement. Okay, the well bore is pre-fractured and sealed to prevent subsequent fracturing. Mathematical models are used to design the well bore strengthening material, as I told you, especially for the BSD. Calculate the required fracture width and the particle size distribution for the well bore strengthening material. Well bore strengthening material is added at moderate concentration while drilling, or added as bells. They can be added as in moderate concentration, okay, while drilling, and you have to take care of the shell shaker mesh screens at this type, or they are used as this is called the continuous addition, or the other type is called the bell technique. We will talk about each one of them inshallah. The formation is pressured. Okay, is pressured every stand to build a hoop stress or ECD is raised to the desired level. The stress cage technique also, as you know, okay, about the strengthening of the formation. The first one is the coarser material. The coarse material is wedged here, okay, as the fracture is widened. Large particles are forced into the formation and they are wedged into the fracture mouth, as you see here, to build or to create the bridge. And over it, the medium ones, or the medium particles are added over it, okay, or are over it. Then the fine, okay, then the fine particles are over them, and the ultra fine are over and over. So this is the sequence: the coarse, then the medium, then the fine, and the other is the ultra fine. And because each one of them is plugging the bores between each size of them. For example, the coarse one, the coarser ones are the first, then the medium plugs the bores between the coarse solids. Then the fine ones plugs the bores between the medium one and the ultra fine between the fine one. So they are making very strong solid, very strong solids for the filter cake, and they don't permit too much filtrate inside it. And as I told you, the dissipated, the trapped pressure here makes more solidification or more consolidated of the bridge from here, because they are from the both the sides, from here and from here, from the well bore side and from the trapped pressure here, and the pressure drop can lead to strengthening the well bore. What is the difference between the well bore strengthening material and the LCM material? Actually, the LCM or the loss circulation material, all material that stops the mud loss, but the well bore strengthening material are tough and granular solids or sealants only. Okay, so we don't use flakes, we don't use insoluble salts, we don't use blades, We don't use laminates or soft granules. But instead, we use here the marble, the synthetic graphite, the hard and granular fibers, and we will use also swellable or reactive materials. The acceptable wellbore strengthening material, large, tough, and granular, as you see here, the nut hucks, the graphite, the marble, the ground petroleum coke. But the unacceptable are the flake graphites, are the flake calcium, are the mica, and the cellulose blends. You have to take care, very important, about when you are making stress strengthening to the hole, okay, by using the shale shaker system. It's called here screening out for the drill cuttings are used and recovers the recycled wellbore strengthening material to be recycled again. You have to use very, very coarse shale shaker screens, for example, ABI 20, ABI 30, ABI 40 maximum. Why? Because in order not to separate, or in order not to separate the wellbore strengthening material or the bridging material over the shale shaker from the mud. So its function will be will not be used. So take care of this very important note. So for the short intervals, bypass the shale shakers. For long intervals, screen out the wellbore strengthening material with the shale shakers. The most effective solution is a system used for wellbore strengthening material recovery system. Okay, it is here used as you know. Okay, so what are the procedures? The two procedures for wellbore strengthening procedures strengthening. Okay, number one, drilling ahead or continuous method. Number two is the bell method. How to make the first one and how to make the second one? Drilling ahead or continuous method. The entire drilling fluid system is loaded or needed to be treated with desired wellbore strengthening material. Blend while drilling through the weak zones. So while drilling, we have to load the system, for example, with the wellbore strengthening material or with the bridging material in order to make strengthening to the wall. Okay, the wellbore strengthening material has a broad range of particle size, including large particles. Therefore, the shakers need to be fitted is very coarse, for example, to be 20 to 40 ABI or mesh screen, or coarser to keep the effective material in the system or bypass the shakers. It's desirable and necessary to keep the full particle size range in the system. As the weak zone is drilled, small short fractures will be created, but probed and sealed with the wellbore strengthening material, and so that the weak zones will be strengthened as the mud weight density is raised, more small fractures are formed and plugged. This method is the most effective, however, it limits drilling about 500 feet because of the buildup of drilled solids in the system. So this is the drilling method. Okay, number two, the bell method. The bell method, from its name, it's a bell. So at first you have to drill to the predetermined top of the stronger rock, so the bottom of the weak rock. Okay, the bottom of the weak rock using low mud weight. Okay, using low mud weight. Then circulate hole clean at this point, okay, and while drilling, build, you have to build or to make the wellbore strengthening material build, okay, with some bridging material with a volume enough to cover the entire open hole plus 100 feet up into the casing plus 10 barrels. Okay, this is very important for calculations. Then check the tool tolerance with manufacturer or downhole drilling surface company to reduce or prevent the plugging from the tools, like for example the LWD or the MWD tools, to avoid any problem to it. This bill should have good suspending properties to prevent the settling of the large calcium carbonate particles in the drill string. Spot the bill in the open hole and up into the casing, leaving about 10 barrels in the drill pipe. Okay, continue for the bill method. Perform a series of FIT or formation integrity tests to force the particles of the wellbore strengthening material into the wellbore wall at the weak zones, and bump down the drill pipe at a controlled rate of quarter barrel per minute. Then carefully plot the pressure versus the time and record the volumes bumped and returned. Whenever the pressure volume line starts bending over, stop the bumping and then make relief, or if the well breaks down, stop bumping for sure. If the fracture gets too far from the wellbore, this method may fail, so take care of this. Bleed the pressure over about a minute, okay? Then make repetition again to the FIT. Wait for 5 minutes, then do the next FIT test to allow any leakage to occur in the fracture if the zone is permeable, okay? So take care of this very important method. Repeat until the desired wellbore pressure is achieved. Okay. No need to know this information. Okay, thank you very much, my friends, for this lesson. It's called stress cage technique. This is very important lesson to in the advanced med school. If this video appeals to you, please share, like, and subscribe to my channel. It's very important and to encourage us to continue. Thank you very much, and see you later, inshallah, about a new lesson later, inshallah. Thank you.